We've got a polar bear wandering around the North Pole. Let's see what his velocity is. So we start, I didn't read the North Pole bit at first. So like we go, never eat slimy worms. So he starts out going south and then east and then 1 meter north to return to his starting point. And I was like, we're not at our starting point. We're like this far away, but he's at the North Pole. So like, I don't know. So we're at the top of the globe. So he went south and then east and then north. And then he did end up where he started because special North Pole weirdness. That's amusing, but not important. He walked in a triangle and ended up back where he started. So the question is, did he go 3 kilometers or did he go 0 kilometers? Okay, so he asked the average velocity. So velocity goes with displacement. And speed goes with distance. So the total distance, that's what your Fitbit tracks. That's like every step. If you go to the store and come back home and the store's a mile away, the distance traveled 2 miles. You took those steps. The displacement though, zero. How far are you from where you started? Zero. You didn't go anywhere. Even though you went somewhere, but at the end of the day you came home, so your displacement is zero. So speed is distance over time, and velocity is displacement over time. So this is one of those like vocab annoying ones. I'm so sorry. So the velocity is displacement over time. So if we end up back where we started, that means our displacement is zero, which means the velocity is zero. The end. Now, if they had asked for speed, we could find that. So speed is distance over time. So that would be 3 kilometers in 45 minutes, which is 0.75 an hour. Right, because 45 minutes is like 3/4 of an hour. So 3 divided by 0.75. So that's 4 kilometers per hour. That is the speed, if he asked that. But he didn't. He asked for velocity. And the next test, if he asks for speed, that's how you do it. So you have to be really careful with those kinds of things, okay?